everybody, my name's Chris, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Spider Squarepants Battle for Bikini Bottom! In the last episode, we killed Robo Patrick, and in this episode, we got a fair going first. I think the fastest spot to go would be here? Yeah, I'll try that out. 1 second! Hooray! We've done it, apparently. Is there not a box somewhere around me outside? I always forget where these two socks are, specifically, because this level does kind of feel very samey. Is there one up there? Oh, God. There is one over here. That's right. I remember now. It's up there, just on up there. Let's fast forward. Okay. Why is that? Oh, the water level did lower, didn't it? Let's fast forward over there, shall we? Okay, so here's the first one. Say hello to my little poopy robots mess with me. I hate when they mess with me. I don't remember there's a way to like blow these up whenever I want to, is there? Oh, you press L again. And then! Okay. I may have done goof that, but don't worry about it. And I think actually the first sock is. What? Earlier in the level. So I think I want to reload. Oh, shit. Ah, shit. So you blow all these up, and that makes a sock appear. Kind of weird, but you know how it is. Okay, so let's actually go. Scary? Okay! I think, yeah, it's right at the bottom of this hill. I think, hey, that can reappeared! I just realized. Like a spring breeze. Hopefully it's over here and I'm not misremembering. That is possible. Misremembering, aren't I? Curious as I sure am. Okay, I guess it's a little bit farther up the hill. Jellyfish field, also not very much of a field, more of a very mountainous area. And is it right there? I think it's up there actually. So we want to work our way up. Okay, fast forward away. Okay, so here we are. We have a little bowling range here. Steer right. Wow, I suck. Oh brother, this guy stinks. I do kind of see what the game journalists were saying. A lot of people were joking on the game journalists because they couldn't, like, the bowling mechanic kind of sucks. And they're kind of right. These switches are too small. You do more of a roll-up. What's the word? Oh, my God. You do more of a, like this. Whatever this. A start-up. Okay, thank God that worked. Then you do in the original game. So, like, you could stand all the way back here. And I guess you could stand over here. But it's like... Yeah, I guess that works, but just like, look at that! I'm almost off the switch already. I even released a little bit early. Let's go. See, I almost like walk off the switch even from there, so just, I don't know, it does feel a little weird. I do think you walk not even a little bit too far, way too far forward. Alright, next up, our final thing we gotta do is go to downtown Bikini Bottom. Hello, it's me, a friendly neighbor, Chris! Well, I guess it's here, right? Why would they put you here for? Wait, I could totally get that, I bet. You're supposed to be on the other side of this. This is actually a switch. Okay, it doesn't work. Fine, we'll go to the other side. I don't know... Don't know exactly what... You spent this... was supposed to lull me to the spatula, so I don't know why it put me on the wrong... You know what? I bet that was the game devs fucking up again. Yeah, see? This is how you're supposed to do this. Okay, missed. Oh, I missed. Okay, I missed again. Let's maybe stand a bit more over here. Whoa, you see that? The missile starts off very fast and goes slow, then picks up speed again. Oh my God! This is so hard to control in this game. The control lags around. Oh my God! The cruise bubble does not feel good in this game, man. It's like ice physics, you know, where you got, like this part feels, oh, nope. When you start to go in a direction, you're good the initial touch, but if you try to like pivot really quickly, you're fucked. It's really easy to overcorrect. Jesus Christ, that feels terrible. What did that do? Platforms were supposed to appear. Why did the... Do I have to go around again? Hold on a minute. Did they mess up how the platforms spawn? Huh? They did. That's not how this is supposed to be. Wow. Good job, game devs. That makes no sense. Why would they have it do that? Oh, sand. Thank you. I'll take that! And I guess we switch back to Sandy? I feel like that's gonna disappear when we change to Sandy, that platform. Let's see what happens here. Someone explain to me how a bust at the top of a sea needle works? I guess that's kind of the joke, most likely, huh? I hate that when people do that with video games, like, wait a minute! What's your bust up of shit? And while this is a little bit less explicitly a joke, but when things are, like, obviously, like, when like, a great example is when they, when the SpongeBob episode where it's, like, there's fire underwater, it's like, wait a minute, hey, with the foil in the water! It's like, yeah, congratulations, you figured out the joke, that's the joke, there we go, we have 100% Bikini Bottom, we have 100% Jellyfish Fields, and now we go to, oh, we're missing one, interesting, top of the chum buggy, let's go! Alright, we're back! Oh, look at that. Ugh. Wait, it loaded in great and then the quality went down. What the hell, dude? These sounds look terrible. We forgot to do this, so let's get in here.
They serve food here, yes, but they don't serve
love.
Flash! Authorities have confirmed that the robots running amok through Bikini Bottom are indeed coming from the chum bucket. Yes, right where you're standing. Plankton, owner of the Chum Bucket, and best known for the creation of robots whose sole purpose is to cause mayhem and destruction, has denied any involvement.
And then stomp on your children! And stomp on your children's children!
This has been a Bikini Bottom news flash.
Is it gonna explode? What? It just despawned! Aw, the TV explodes in the original game. Chum Bucket, Chum Burger, Chum Fries, Chum Shake, Chum on a Stick. Chumbalaya! New! Chum chili! Chum pie! Ew. I don't like chum pie, that's gross. Hello. Hello. Not too sure why those are there. That's a spatula, right? Yes. Yes, so you need 75 spatulas to beat this game, which is actually, like, kind of a lot, man. Like, in Mario, what is it, like, isn't it... It's 60 to beat the whole game, right? It's literally half. And this game is 3/4, okay? This camera can stop doing that! It just... Stupid. This game is so dumb with someone with stupid shit. Also, god dang, I keep forgetting to start the timer again. You can't even adjust the camera up there. Also, apparently people, like, figuring out a lot of glitches regarding this, which I don't think this was in the original game, if I remember correctly. Like, you could, like, glitch your way into the boss with this or something. Yeah, look at that. It, like, flings you up. It's real weird, dude.
This sticks.
Did they kill me? Hello? Cool. Good game. Good game. Okay, so I think that's it. What do we gotta do here? So, whoops, I keep doing that, man. Yeah, that's it. We have 100% the main section of Bikini Bottom. Nice, nice, nice. All right, so now what level do we tackle first? Do we do Kelp Forest? We need 50. But there's also SpongeBob's Dream, which requires no spatulas. But chronologically, at least in the original game... Whoa, did that instantly explode? Sure did. Wait, did it? I don't know. The clouds are loading there as if it didn't blow up. Anyways, in the original game, chronologically, SpongeBob Dream actually comes last with Kelp Forest, Flying Dutchman, and then SpongeBob Dream. And it's also my favorite level, so I might do that. But there's no real chronological order in this game, is there? Because... Oh, wait. Maybe not. All right, I thought maybe, like, because look at this. Chum Bucket, like, indicates the last part of the level, and then you go... three options to go. I'm just trying to, like, figure out this map. Oh, I see how this works now. Okay, so when you start off the game, you're in Bikini Bottom, then you go Jellyfish Fields, Goo Lagoon, or Downtown Bikini Bottom. I guess they just have the two boss fights on the side here. It doesn't really make much sense for them to be there, I guess, but... And then you beat the first boss, and you go Mermalair, Sand Mountain, and Rock Bottom, and then you get to the section of the Chum Bucket Lab, and then you can go these three directions. And then with the Mr. Krabs and Patrick doing the course. This start screen makes a bit more sense, or pause screen makes a bit more sense now. It's still very weird though. But like, okay, Sand Mountain is the last one that you could go into. Goo Lagoon is the last one. So maybe like Flying Dutchman's Graveyard is supposed to be the last level. I don't know, man. Let's just do Kelp Forest first.
Here we are in the Kelp Forest, an interesting area with many sights to see, for those that don't get hopelessly lost first.
Yeehaw! Yeehaw! I like his little dance moves. The robot. Oh gee, wait, really? I don't remember a giant mountain falling on them. So check this shell, the only enemy in the game you can't fuck with. This hand thing, wait, did you do 2 hearts of damage? No, it doesn't. So, Kelp Forest. When I race Matt, the entire race he was complaining, or in Kelp Forest, he's like, wow, it's impossible to see in Kelp Forest. In the original game, of course. And I was like, what are you talking about? It's fine. And at that point, I was playing like on an older TV. It wasn't like a CTR or anything, or CRT? CRT. But it was a pretty old TV, and like the game looked fine on me, but for some reason, certain areas in video games that are dark, that are older games, look absolutely terrible on new TVs. You can boost the brightness all you want, and it'll just look terrible, and Kelp Forest is one of those. Playing this game more recently on a newer TV was hell when I streamed this game a couple years ago, and I ran into the same issue playing, Pitfall Lost Expedition. Just something about playing old games on new TVs is terrible. Okay, good. Oh, alright. I'm gonna get all these robots in there, but never mind. Oh my god, I better not die, these assholes! Good lord, I need underpants. So I don't know what's up with that. I don't know why old TVs make, or new TVs make older dark levels look way darker than usual, but they do. So here's one of the most obscure socks in the game. Check this out. Fuck, I messed it up. Oh, that still works somehow. I thought you had to break all these like in a row in one shot, otherwise this doesn't work, but it worked for some reason. So yep, that song is 100% bullshit. I don't know how you're supposed to figure that out. That's some bullshit, you know, old school collectathon obscure shit. Like, if anyone figured that without looking that up, I don't understand how. Okay. So here's how you're supposed to kill these dudes. You're supposed to do that. As a kid, I would always like double jump and attack them like that to get rid of them, but alright, so here, this might kill me. No! Fuck. Yep, there's no shot at me doing that. Alright, we have to reload and do that again at some point.
Hi, Mrs. Puff. Driving class isn't out here today, is it?
No, SpongeBob. Why do you say that? Do you think we'd have class out here just to hide from you? How silly. I'm just gathering twigs for the winter. Yes, that's it.
Oh, can I help? I have a merit badge in twig gathering.
Actually, you can help with something else. These robots showed up and scared all the students, campers, off into the forest. Before the ranger arrives, someone needs to go out and find them.
I'll help you find them, Mrs. Puff. I'm the sponge for the job.
Thanks, SpongeBob. I'll make sure to give you a nice reward when you found all of them.
I like how she says students. I mean campers, but like SpongeBob is a student. Wouldn't you recognize them? Ranger. Go, go, Power Ranger! Alright, do we get the cutscene? They we do. Yay, they give us the cutscene, even though there's no toilet in there. So here's how I used to fight these guys. It doesn't matter, but. Oh shit, oh, I'm on top of that dude and taking no damage. It's kind of hard to tell where these guys' flames hurt. Bam! Oh! Wait, you just kill the top one and it kills them! Interesting. Right, that shrivels to non-existence. Wonderful. So anyways, going back to like the darkness thing. I'm really, like, they really boost the light levels in here, which is thank god, dude. I wonder if like in 20 years from now, when this game's old as hell, and then we play them on even newer TVs, if this will also look terrible. There's surely no way to know. But Kelp Forest, I do mention I like really like jungle levels and all that, but this level's very dark, and that makes me not like it as much. So even though this is a level I would typically like quite a bit, the fact that it's so damn dark in here kind of like ruins. I like happy-go-lucky. Does he have bones in his pocket? I guess for his dogs. Come on. Do a little flappy hat. Flappy hat. I wish I didn't delete Flappy Hat on my phone. It was a great game, and I could have sold my phone for millions of dollars. Oh, they don't. Oh, shit! I forgot that happened. The valise fall up from under you. Oh, so yeah, the collectible in this level is children. I don't remember what this is. Keeping ZR for this? That feels more correct, but it is not. Ah, this raises platforms, doesn't it? Yes, indeed it does. That kid slapped his own ass. Weird. So I guess you could say, though, like, oh, maybe this is just different class, or this is just different driver's ed class. That's very possible, but shut up. All right, shut up. Cool. Those leaves, I feel like those leaves should pop up. Okay, SpongeBob found him before even I found him. All right. All right, Miss Puff. I guess we need to be Patrick up here. Right. This level is very, like, this part level is actually very small, but it's very compact. We could actually, like, if we were to run from one side of the level to the other to the next loading screen, it would take, like, probably, like, 10 seconds. It's very quickly. Is there anything down there I care about? I guess we just go down.
Feel like a new sponge.
Take a little peek skis from my skeletons. Okay. I was hoping that wouldn't hit that Thunder Tiki, but it did. Whoops. Whoopsies. All right, there's nothing down here. This was pointless. Really living life on the edge right now. How much health do I have? Not enough. Is there anything this way? Nope. Nope. Oh, there's... We can go that way, though. Hoppity hop, hop, hoppity hop, hop. Look at SpongeBob. I definitely should not have hit that. That was pretty far off. I have no idea what I'm at for time here, so hopefully this isn't a very long. Well, maybe if it is, who cares, right? Maybe you guys like the long episodes. I don't know. Jon Snow. We'll make it through this area, then we'll probably call her an episode there. Oh no, I just made the realization. You know, okay, so I've been talking about the three hardest challenges in this game, right? You guys know. 3 years running. The marble in the Mermalair. The eight Sandman. Cool. And the last challenge, the last big three, is in this level. Hey, we reloaded. Did we get our We do. We get another shot at this. Stop. Thank you. Oh, thank you. All right, let's. Is there a better way to, like, line my camera up for this? I don't know, man. Ah! How the fuck are you supposed to do that? Good God! I thought I was doing that pretty good there. Stupid fire. All right, we are gonna have to turn into Patrick in a second here. Whoa! Nice! Oh, shit. Oh my God! I got hit with a wobble combo! All right. Oh, please don't get stuck on a random rock, SpongeBob. Boom, boom! Stop, stop. Oh, shit! I hit the wrong button. Don't ask how I hit B instead of A. It's kind of hard to confuse, but... Shit, 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 shit. Yes. Stop. Stop. I don't know how you're not hitting me, dude. Laser dude. You hit me so many times, but somehow not registered. Now that guy's the one getting pissed. Like, stupid developers of this game. They won't register my attack. What is this shit? I wonder if there's a way to... Do these give you shiny objects? Okay. Sorry. Could be wrong. Can you reach me from here? You can't. Can I one-shot you with this?
Say hello to my little bubble friend.
I don't know. Ah, bruh. Body. That'd be a very bad idea. Oh, he almost got me. I would have died.
Feel like a new sponge.
I need to get up there somehow. How do I do that again? We get there SpongeBob specifically. Maybe we gotta do the Patrick stuff first and then we can come back to SpongeBob?
SpongeBob!
Alright, let's change into Patrick. This is definitely getting pretty long here, and we do have a lot more. Well, not a lot more, but maybe we should actually just call it here. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please feel free to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already. In the next episode, we'll finish up this first area and make our way through the Kelp Forest. Where's the bus stop? Oh yeah, it's like down here or something, isn't it? Yeah, what a weird spot. You'd think it'd be like where the campsite is, but... Alright, talk to you guys tomorrow! Bye-bye!
It's me, Patrick!